For some things in life, you only get one chance. A number of professional sports teams and athletes only had one shot at glory. Some of them made the most of it by winning the championship while others blew it. But if you're one of the more fortunate athletes, you just might get a second chance at glory, and some of those teams took full advantage of that second chance. I'm Justin Fraction, and today we present 10 teams that lost the championship, then won it the following year. At TPS, we post videos every single day, so don't forget to click the subscribe button to subscribe. Then click the notification bell to be notified when we post a new video. And a big shout out to Fatboy for suggesting this list. We hope you enjoyed it, and if you do, leave your ideas down below, and you never know, we might use one and give you a shout out. Number 10, 2012 Miami Heat. No matter how much the haters wanted to deny it, we knew it was only a matter of time before LeBron James finally won his first NBA championship in South Beach. Nobody in the East could stack up with LeBron, Dwayne Wade, and Chris Bosh. But still, it was fun to see the Dallas Mavericks upset them in the 2011 NBA Finals. Most of America cheered for Kevin Durant's Oklahoma City Thunder to hand LeBron another loss in the 2012 NBA Finals. Unfortunately, it wasn't meant to be. Miami won the championship in 5 games, a year after being upset by the Mavs. Number 9, 2015 Kansas City Royals. The 2014 Royals were an underdog story for the ages. They snatched a second wildcard spot and made the playoffs for the first time in 29 years. Next thing we knew, they met the San Francisco Giants in the World Series. Their Cinderella run ended without a miracle, as the Royals fell in 7 games. Many expected the Royals to regress in 2015, but that didn't happen. Kansas City finally took care of unfinished business, defeating the New York Mets in 5 games to win their first World Series in 30 years. So much for being a one-year wonder. Number 8, 2014 San Antonio Spurs. As everyone remembers, the Spurs really choked Game 6 of the 2013 NBA Finals. Instead of celebrating a 5th championship under Greg Popovich and Tim Duncan, they let LeBron and the Heat defend their title in a thrilling 7-game series. But that's okay, because the Spurs would redeem themselves a year later with supreme shooting all over the court. San Antonio crushed Miami in 5 games to capture the 2014 NBA championship. Finally, Duncan won ring number 5. That result would also lead to the breakup of Miami's Big 3. Number 7, 1970 Baltimore Orioles. The Orioles had one of the most dominant seasons ever in 1969, winning 109 games before falling to the New York Mets in the World Series. Just when it looked like the O's blew their one chance to capture it all, they bounced back in 1970. Baltimore won a whopping 108 games that year. Behind superstars Bill Powell and Brooks Robinson, the Orioles would reach the Fall Classic once again. And this time, they took down the powerhouse Cincinnati Reds in 5 games, winning their second championship in franchise history. Number 6, 2009 Pittsburgh Penguins. Armed with 2 young world-class superstars in Sidney Crosby and Evgeny Malkin, the Pittsburgh Penguins reached the 2008 Stanley Cup Final. But the better and more experienced Detroit Red Wings finished them off in a rather close 6-game series. Everyone knew the Penguins would get another shot eventually, and they did. The next year, Pittsburgh met Detroit in the finals once again. This time, the Penguins emerged victorious with a thrilling 2-1 victory in Game 7. It was the franchise's 3rd championship in their history. Number 5, 1989 Oakland Athletics. The 1988 Athletics were star-studded with legendary pitcher Dennis Eckersley and slugger Mark McGwire. But the California rival Los Angeles Dodgers were a bit better, defeating the Athletics in 5 games to capture the 1988 World Series championship. It was a tough loss for the Athletics, but they bounced back like a real winner. They won 99 games in 1989 and would sweep the San Francisco Giants to win the World Series. It was the 9th championship in the franchise's history. Number 4, 1989 Detroit Pistons. Yep, 1989 was the year of teams redeeming themselves after losing a title the year before, at least for the Pistons and Athletics. The Bad Boys Pistons lost a crushing 7-game series to Magic Johnson's Los Angeles Lakers in the 1988 NBA Finals. But Isaiah Thomas, Dennis Rodman, and company were ultra-motivated for revenge in 1989, and they got it. Detroit used terrific defense to slow down the Lakers' high-flying offense, pulling off a surprising 4-game sweep to capture the NBA championship. And if that wasn't enough, the Pistons would go on to defend their title in 1990 as well. Number 3, 1984 Edmonton Oilers. So as it turned out, the league's best player in Wayne Gretzky just wasn't enough to help the Oilers in 1983. The New York Islanders dynasty wasn't ready to relinquish its crown as they swept Edmonton in the 1983 Stanley Cup Finals. But history changed in 84. Gretzky and the Oilers took down the Islanders in 5 games, ending New York's bid for a 5th straight championship. That was it for the Islanders dynasty. Edmonton would win 5 Stanley Cups between 1984 and 1990. It just had to go through that learning experience of a painful loss in the final first. Number 2, 2016 Cleveland Cavaliers. LeBron James left Miami in 2014, choosing to rejoin his hometown Cleveland Cavaliers. King James was trying to fulfill his promise to bring his city its first championship victory since 1964. Well, the Cavs fell short to the Golden State Warriors, losing the 2015 NBA Finals in 6 games. A year later, Golden State set countless records highlighted by 73 regular season victories. Cleveland met Golden State in the finals once again, falling behind 3 games to 1. However, James rallied his squad to win the next 3 games. Boom! The Cavs had their first title in NBA history. The Warriors missed out on legendary status, and LeBron James made good on his promise. And number one, 1972 Miami Dolphins. What do you think you'd do after you get crushed 24-3 in the Super Bowl? Just ask the 1972 Miami Dolphins. Well, they're the only team in history to pull off a perfect season, and after losing Super Bowl VI, they won all 14 regular season games plus their next two playoff games. Up next was the Washington Redskins in Super Bowl VII. Miami avenged his loss from the previous year, all right. They defeated Washington 14-7, winning their first ever Super Bowl, and in perfect style, too. Future Super Bowl runner-ups just learned from the 72 Dolphins. They set the blueprint perfectly. And a bonus number one, 2018 New England Patriots. When the Patriots lost to the Philadelphia Eagles in Super Bowl 52, lots of folks thought that the dynasty had ended. Tom Brady was too old, Rob Gronkowski was slowing down, other teams in the AFC were catching up. Unless you were living in New England, you probably didn't think that Brady would see another Super Bowl ring again. Well, friendly reminder number 101,275. That you cannot count out the Patriots until Bill Belichick retires. Even with a flawed roster, a slowly declining Brady, and a past his prime Rob Gronkowski, the hooded genius found a way to bring a sixth Lombardi trophy to Foxborough. A powerful ground game led by Sonny Mitchell, a revived Julian Edelman, and an elite defense all came together at the right time. The Patriots dismantled opponents throughout the postseason. They beat the Los Angeles Chargers and Kansas City Chiefs in the postseason, two teams with better regular season records. Heck, the scary Los Angeles Rams are absolutely no match for the Pats in Super Bowl 53. Brady had one of his worst outings ever, and yet, the Patriots won 13-3 and captured the Super Bowl. So much for the dynasty ending. Should we just hand them Super Bowls 54 and 55 now? What other teams won the championship a year after losing it? Let us know your thoughts in the comment section down below, and don't forget to like and subscribe. We'll see you guys next time.